After that, we had Miz TV, the infamous Miz TV, with The Miz, Maryse, and guest stars LaVar Ball, LaMelo Ball, and Lonzo Ball. So, I don't watch basketball whatsoever, okay? The only reason why these names sounded familiar to me in the slightest was because I've seen them tweeted about a million times on Twitter. I've seen people who I know follow basketball and shit like that talk about these guys constantly. But I could still not tell you for the life of me what they were known for prior to this show. And then I found out, I thought LaVar Ball was a basketball player. He's not. He's the father. I mean, you guys probably know better than I do. I'm just kind of explaining this really for myself. But LaVar Ball is the father. And Lonzo Ball and LaMelo Ball are his sons. Now, Lonzo Ball got drafted to the Lakers, which obviously emanate from Los Angeles, which is why they had him on this show, in the Staples Center, whatever. He just got drafted to the Lakers, I think the first draft pick, like a week or two ago. LaMelo Ball is like maybe 15, 16 years old. He's a really good high school basketball player. Okay. So WWE obviously brought them out for a mainstream, to garner mainstream attention. I get it. They got exactly what they wanted. Maybe for all the wrong reasons, but they got exactly what they wanted. So I guess be careful what you ask for, Vince, because you got a lot of mainstream publicity from this segment for one kid saying the N-word twice. Twice! How does that happen? So anyway, with this segment, long story short, it goes completely off the rails. Once LaVar Ball comes out there with LaMelo Ball, and then they introduce Lonzo, they did not take this seriously whatsoever. Lonzo, I know they were promoting their fucking big baller brand shit, whatever. But Lonzo Ball comes out there in friggin' slippers, in whatever, in like complete casual clothing, like he could not give two shits, and I'm sure he didn't. I know they called him over the weekend to be on the show, and they were on the show. LaVar Ball is a complete goof, which I saw a lot of people laughing about it, like, oh, this is so funny. You know what? No, he made a mockery of, I don't know, not maybe of wrestling, but he took it completely as a complete joke. It made Miz look like an idiot. Dean Ambrose, I have no idea why the hell he was out there. I don't know whether he was out there to cut this thing short, or they cut the segment short because it was so bad. And because Dean Ambrose came out after all this shit ensued with the three kids, with the three LaVar, with the three Ball family members, and then Miz and Maryse, and LaVar Ball's about to fight the Miz. Dean Ambrose comes out, Miz's arch rival, wearing a big baller brand t-shirt. That's what Dean Ambrose has come to in 2017. The lunatic fringe supporting the merchandise of basketball players. That's what Dean Ambrose has been reduced to, apparently. But so he comes out and says, oh, great balls of fire. The Ball family. I keep on saying LaVar, but that's the first name of the father. Great balls of fire. The Ball family. Ha ha ha. What a connection. And then he walks off. And that was the end of it. They cut it short. I'm sure they cut it short because they knew how big of a train wreck this was. But it's not like they brought out Ambrose after the kid had said the N-word. So he said, beat this N-word's ass, is exactly what he said. I think he said it twice. But he had said that as Ambrose was coming out. He said it to his dad in respect to The Miz, as he was talking to The Miz. So it's not like he had said and they brought out Ambrose, like, oh shit, you know, all hands on deck. We got to cut this thing short now. Bring out Ambrose so we can go to commercial. That wasn't what happened, because he said it as Ambrose was coming out. So whatever Ambrose was supposed to say, he said what he was supposed to say. Maybe there was more to it than that. I had read via, again, the Wrestling Observer newsletter. They had mentioned in their piece this week, they had reported that the family was supposed to be at ringside for the subsequent six-man tag team match between Miz, Slater, Rhino, Dallas, Axel, Ambrose, whatever. But because of what happened with the kid, they nixed it. And they were reportedly furious backstage. I mean, what do you expect? The kid's 15 years old. They brought this all together. They did. This was a whole last-minute deal. I'm sure they had no idea what the hell they were doing. LaVar Ball is a complete goof. The guy's a total idiot. He did not take this seriously at all. It made wrestling look like a complete joke. I mean, for all the gifs going around of LaVar Ball, like, running around the ring and doing the crazy-ass walk to the ring and looking like an idiot and all that other shit, people are like, oh my god, that's so funny. You know what? Yeah, other people are laughing at this too, but they're laughing at how dumb it is. Like, it's people are saying how bad it's funny, how bad it's so bad it's good, whatever. And I can almost get that, but like, people that aren't wrestling fans, like, as a wrestling fan, I was embarrassed to watch that on Monday. I was embarrassed to watch that. And to people that aren't wrestling fans, that see the gifs on Twitter and online of LeVar Ball walking down to the ring looking like an idiot, they're like, wow, wrestling really is a joke. It's a fucking joke. I was talking to someone at work yesterday about this. I'm like, oh no, again, I'm embarrassed to be a wrestling fan. And he had turned on Raw, he was flipping through the channels, and he had said he had came across, and as soon as he started this conversation, and we're pretty good friends, and he brought up how he had mentioned that he was flipping through the channels, and he's like, yeah, and I came across Raw, and I'm like, oh no, the Ball Family segment, Miss TV, and he's like, yeah, how'd you know? I'm like, trust me, I knew exactly where you were going with this before he even started. And he was like, wow, this is really fucking dumb. It's stupid. He's not a wrestling fan, but he understands, like, my passion for it. He gets the business and whatnot. There's very few people like that out there, but they're out there, and he's one of them. And even he agreed. It's dumb. Even as a non-wrestling fan, it was dumb for him. Like, people laughed the first time, but it gets to a point where it's just embarrassing. For the WWE, again, they didn't go out there and tell the kid to say the N-word, but for them to go that far and bringing these people in as a desperate ploy to garner ratings, I know the tie-in there with the Staples Center and the Lakers and in Los Angeles, whatever, but it was completely unnecessary. It was just bad. Like, this brought back bad memories of the absolutely atrocious, absolutely awful segments with the old Raw guest hosts. You remember that gimmick that they cut short after a while because it was so pooped on? It was so universally hated by the fans. They had to get rid of it. For a couple of years there, from like 09 to 2010, 2011, we would get guests all the time, every single week. But more often than not, they were atrocious because they didn't know the product. They would make a complete joke of it. Like, oh, look, I'm on wrestling. Like, shut the fuck up and get off my TV. You're a friggin' joke. We got that. And I mean, it wasn't quite as bad. But we had some actor from Transformers on commentary for the previous six-man tag team match with Balor, Hardy Boys, Samson, Sheamus, and Cesaro talking about some WWE Studios movie coming out. Like, dude, I don't care. He obviously was not a fan of wrestling because he had no idea what the hell was going on. He was obviously being fed lines, took away from the match, go away. But this was 10 times worse. This was not only annoying, it was just flat-out embarrassing. And WWE should be ashamed, ashamed to have put that on their television show on Monday. That's how bad it was. Again, less said about it, the better. I just went on a whole rant about it. I apologize, but that was just complete train wreck TV. That's how bad that was. And here's hoping we never see that family on TV again. That's how bad that shit was.